With nearly 300 music video credits and a career that has spanned almost four decades, director Sophie Muller is recognized as one of the top leading female directors in the industry. Her collaborations with mainstream artists have produced some of the most iconic music videos of our time. Muller's unique style includes both fantastical and minimalistic sets, colorful mise-en-scene, vintage glamour, and captivating narratives. Her seamless editing style that plays with temporality has become a distinct part of her signature. For my research question, I ask, how does Sophie Muller use color and editing in the music videos Cool by Gwen Stefani and She Will Be Loved by Maroon 5 to develop the storyline, engage the audience, and elevate the song's meaning as an auteur? To give a bit of context, the music video for Cool centers on a former couple who have broken up but remain cool with each other as friends. However, it's clear she still has feelings for him even though he has a new girlfriend. The video for She Will Be Loved is about a guy who is in love with his girlfriend's mother, who is lonely and married to an abusive husband. Let's take a look at how Muller utilizes color to signify emotions in these music videos using Natalie Kalmus' journal on color consciousness. The colors of yellow and gold serve an important purpose in Cool. According to Kalmus, yellow and gold symbolize gaiety but can also symbolize, quote, deceit, jealousy, inconstancy in its darker shades, and particularly when it is tinged with green, end quote. When the video shows their past relationship, the yellow background denotes a sense of joy and carefreeness. In contrast, when she is reminiscing about the past on her gold-colored sheets, there is a tint of green, hinting at regret and jealousy for his new life. In She Will Be Loved, yellow is used in a similar way. The yellow-green lighting insinuates his unfaithfulness to his girlfriend and his desire to be with her mother instead. Black also plays a significant role in both videos. Kalmus states, quote, black has a distinctly negative and destructive aspect. It suggests funerals, mourning, it is impenetrable, comfortless, secretive, end quote. The couple's black outfits and Cool indicate the death of a previous relationship and Gwen grieving its loss. At the end of She Will Be Loved, both are also wearing black, symbolizing their guilt and immorality in having and keeping their affair from the daughter. In contrast, the daughter's white robe indicates her purity and innocence. The use of red is also significant in both texts. Kalmus declares that, quote, red suggests blood, life, and love, end quote. In Cool, Gwen is wearing a red dress in one of the flashback sequences, highlighting the excitement and intensity of that relationship. In She Will Be Loved, the mother's smeared red lipstick represents violence at first, but turns to lust and passion when Adam's character goes to comfort her. The mother's red dress in the bar also emphasizes her as the main love interest and object of desire. As you can see, Muller is very intentional with the use of color. They add clarity to the narrative by bringing out emotional undertones and make the videos visually as well as intellectually engaging by playing with our associations of each color in conversation with the song's message. The song achieves a greater level of depth in using those implications to drive the drama forward. Next, I want to look at Muller's editing style and how her choices enhance the development of the narrative. First, I want to address how she plays with temporality. In both music videos, before the song begins, she introduces a flashback sequence that indicates a flood of memories coming back to the character the artist plays. The flashbacks preview what's to come. In She Will Be Loved, this is triggered by Adam looking back, figuratively and literally before he jumps into the pool. In Cool, the flashbacks are brought on by a movement that triggers her to remember a specific moment shared between the two of them. A rush of old memories also surface when they sit down to catch up. In getting a glimpse of what will happen, the viewer is lured in, curious to find out how those images relate to the narrative in the grander scheme. Muller further pulls the audience in by cutting back and forth between close-ups of characters and memories shared between them, creating an emotional climax and increasing tension near the end of the song. Muller is also fond of cross-cutting and match cuts, trademarks of her music videos. She most commonly cross-cuts to a different time, place, or scenario using the graphic match where the cuts are between similar shape forms. In these two videos, these editing techniques are the linking force that connects past to present and fantasy to reality. Here are a few examples in Cool. Them bumping into each other, sitting down, her serving food, laying down, and her flipping her hair. In She Will Be Loved, we see this when he flips her over, when the husband smears her lipstick, and when they're dancing. These cuts bring up interesting situational and emotional comparisons using similar imagery. One graphic match cut that deserves further analysis is the sipping kissing sequence in Cool. In Carol Vernalis' essay, The Kindest Cut, Functions and Meanings of Music Video Editing, she mentions the Cool Shove experiment, which suggests that an image gets its meaning through its juxtaposition with other images. By placing these two shots together, the act of sipping becomes synonymous with kissing, or the thought of kissing, creating intimacy even though they're sitting apart from each other. Although it's not a graphic match cut, the Cool Shove effect still applies in She Will Be Loved, where the edit tells us what the character might be thinking or imagining. The edit goes from Adam, to his girlfriend, to her mother, showing that his true desire is to be with the mother. The effect of the edit is then completed by messages in the music. Bernal states, quote, "The music cannot define the meaning of objects, but it can surely suggest the animating desire that characters bear towards objects or others. We read emotions into the image before us, and with the help of the song, make connections between this image and others in the video," end quote. The match cuts and careful pairing of shots help the flow of the narrative by smoothly bridging time gaps and allowing insight into the minds of the characters. So how does Sophie Muller's use of color and editing make her an auteur? According to Diane Railton and Paul Watson in the chapter Making It Real, Authorship and Authenticity, thematic and stylistic coherence is necessary for a director to be considered an auteur. We can see how Muller's color schemes have thematic consistency in representing the same emotions across both music videos, and stylistic consistency in creating similar vintage aesthetics. The colors support the feelings of romanticism and nostalgia that are pertinent in her work. Additionally, Railton and Watson claim that the music video concept must be the director's interpretation of a song. They state how some argue that the vocal track guides the visual action as the voice of authority. In Sophie Muller's music videos, we can see how it's actually the reverse, where the music video guides our experience of the song. Contradictory to what the song Cool is all about, the music video shows how she's not over him, suggesting the exact opposite. The scenario depicted in She Will Be Loved informs our interpretation of the title, which deepens our understanding of the song. Muller accomplishes this through her editing style, filling in emotional gaps and building characterization and giving us access to the past and the internal thoughts of a character. The study of Sophie Muller's music videos is significant to this class in demonstrating how a music video has the power to shape the perception of a song and what meaning it can add to it through its presentation of certain elements, such as color and editing. In relation to auteur theory, Sophie Muller demonstrates a unique ability to create compelling narratives using formal elements that connect the audience to the video visually and emotionally. Analyzing Muller's choices in color and editing reveals a level of cohesiveness and individuality that supports her status and style as an auteur, a concept we can further consider when viewing music videos that fall under a breadth of a single director or artist's work.